You could call it animation, but this is no cartoon. Instead, this is a tsunami simulation, how the best science available tells geologists what we can expect in various earthquake scenarios. Here, several hours are compressed into minutes.
Well, I've showed it to a couple people and their reaction is, oh! And I think it hits home because at this level, they can pick out where they live.
Karina Forsen is the chief hazard geologist for the Washington Department of Natural Resources.
The inundation in some of these areas is over 60 feet.
And the simulation helps blow up an old assumption that a tsunami generated from a magnitude 9 earthquake off our coast would not do much inside of Puget Sound.
That is something that's new. Before, we've had these static map products that we show inundation, and I believe that it's hard for some people to really visualize and understand what that means and the time that it takes for a wave to travel to some of these locations.
Seattle may see around 5 feet, but Tacoma's Commencement Bay nearly 10. But the simulation also tells us time. Along the outer coast, the time before the wave hit could be as little as 10 to 15 minutes. In Puget Sound, people would have several hours to get to higher ground. The 2011 Tohoku earthquake in Japan brought home the images of what a tsunami could do to an advanced economy. And every vulnerable area in Washington will get a detailed simulation. Bellingham and the San Juans about to be released. And they're not just looking at a tsunami generated along the Cascadia subduction zone.
So this is a model coming out of Alaska, hitting Long Beach, Washington, right here.
Alex Dolce-Mascalo is a tsunami geologist hired just 2 months ago with money appropriated by the legislature to help communities visualize their risk.
As the event starts, and then as the wave becomes closer and closer, it refines, and so we are able to accurately record the wave.
This scenario, a work in progress, will take 3 years to finish these localized simulations. In Olympia, Glenn Farley, King 5 News.